You're watching the Expected Score channel. In this video, we will discuss all the parameters of XGStatistics. We will review each parameter of XGStats from the spreadsheets on the Expected Score website for you to know how to use XGStats for match analysis and in our XGManager program. This video is the complete guide on XGStats. Like this video and keep watching it until the end. Subscribe to our channel not to miss our new video. So let's start. Open the match on the Expected Score website. For example, the game of the 13th day of the English Premier League between Liverpool and Southampton. Here you can see different sections. The first one is Preview. Here you can find brief information about the teams. The main XG parameters for both teams, which you can compare. The results of the last 5 matches for each team, score on fact and the expected score, and the list of previous games between these teams. The following section is Lineups. Here you can find the lineups for the match, starting and substitutions. The next section, Match Review, is very important. The information gets the match review after the game. Here you can see all the shots of Liverpool and Southampton. The XG value of each shot, the minute of a shot, the score on that moment, and the results. Save, miss, goal. Also, here are assigned penalties, own goals and red cards. Pay attention, XG for own goals and penalties not calculated. For the other shots, we calculate the probability to become a goal, XG value of a shot. During the match, each team creates dangerous moments, the shots. We calculate for each of them the probability to become a goal, which reflects in this section. In this way, we calculate the starts for the whole match. For example, we have a game between Liverpool and Southampton. Liverpool has created 3.46 XG and scored 4 goals. That is close to the expected 3.5 goals. Southampton has created 0.63 XG and scored 0 goals. This result is also fair. The team hasn't created dangerous moments even for a goal. But sometimes the results can be less fair. For example, in the match of the first day of the previous season of English Premier League, Leeds has created 0.57 XG, less than a goal, but the team has scored 3 goals. These goals were unfair, and only XG statistics can show you the true results of the match. The following section is Statistics. Here you will find the results of the matches mixed according to the different criteria. Now let's move to the main, the spreadsheet with XG stats on the Expected Score website. In previous video, we have discussed the meaning of XG, how we collect our XG stats, and how it differs from the other XG models. Now it's time to review each parameter of the XG stats. Here you can see the table with the classic statistic parameters and advanced XG parameters. You might know the group of the first 8 parameters, the usual football statistician parameters such as games, wins, draws, and defeats, goals for and goals against, their difference and the number of points. Then starts the XG parameters, and the first one is XG itself. We review the results at the moment of the 14th day of English Premier League. Liverpool has 42.4 XG now. What do these XG numbers mean? This result is the sum of all expected goals, dangerous moments which the team has created during the season. Liverpool has created 42.4 XG, and in fact, the team has scored 43 goals. The next column is the XGA parameter, which shows how many dangerous moments the team allows her rivals create close to its goals. Liverpool has 13.7 XGA, and the team has missed 12 goals in reality. In this spreadsheet, we can see all the results for the teams, both home and away, but you can divide them. Click on the home button to see the results only for the home games. Liverpool has played 7 home games, scored 21.3 XG, and 18 goals on his field. If you want to check the level of teams in away games, click on away games. In away games, Liverpool has 21.1 XG and 25 goals. So XG is the base parameter in XG stats, the sum of all the dangerous moments, expected goals which the team has created. XGA is also the base parameter in XG stats, which means the sum of the expected goals against the team. The following parameter is XGD, which shows the difference between the expected goals for and the expected goals against. Liverpool has 28.7 XGD. The positive result means that the team has created more expected goals than allows her rivals create. Leeds, for example, has a negative result, minus 6.8 XGD, which means that the team has created fewer expected goals than her rivals. The last parameter from the first group of XG parameters is GD minus XGD. That is a measure of luck. GD minus XGD parameter shows the team luck, which is the difference between the real goals for and goals against, and the expected goals for and the goals against. We can see that Liverpool has 2.3 GD minus XGD, so the difference between the real goals and the expected goals is not significant. The luckiest team on the 14th day of English Premier League is Chelsea. In this season, it's a lucky team whose GD minus XGD parameter is 10.7. Chelsea scored 4 goals more than expected and conceded 6 goals less than expected. This parameter is very helpful. It helps sports bettors to find undervalued and overvalued teams, and you can use this information for match analysis or making your strategies. Move on to the next parameters. Review XG shot. This parameter reflects the average danger of the shots that team creates. To calculate XG shot, we divide the sum of XG by the number of shots of the team. The average danger of Liverpool's shot is 0.17. Manchester City's XG shot is 0.12. Southampton's 0.1. The strongest teams usually create the shots with the average danger from 0.16 to 0.20 XG. This parameter is also important, and you can include it in your sports betting strategies. XGA shot parameter has the same meaning, but it reflects the average danger of the moments that the team allows their rivals to create. For example, Manchester City allows its rivals to create moments with 0.09 XG, Southampton with 0.14 XG. Now let's review more advanced and useful parameters, which you should use in your betting strategies. The first one is XG90. This parameter reflects the number of dangerous moments for 90 minutes. How do we calculate this parameter? We divide the sum of XG from the current season by all the minutes the team has played in the current season. The team can play 92, 94, 97 minutes or even more. Despite the absence of minutes in XG spreadsheets, we take them into account. Divide all XG by all minutes and multiply the result by 90. As a result, we have a number of expected goals for, which the team creates per 90 minutes. Liverpool creates almost 3 goals per 90 minutes. Its XG90 parameter is 2.79, which is the highest result on the 14th day of English Premier League. Tottenham, for example, creates a goal per 90 minutes. XGA90 parameter calculates in the same way, but here we can use the number of expected goals against. Manchester City has the best defense according to the XGA90 parameter. The team allows its rivals to create only 0.52 XG per 90 minutes. The following parameter is XG90 plus XGA90, the sum of two parameters, XG90 and XGA90. This parameter is good for making bets on total over or total under. XG90 plus XGA90 is one of the prior parameters to predict the total score in a match. If we sum XG90 plus XGA90 parameter of the home team and XG90 plus XGA90 parameter of the away team, we will get the approximate number of expected for and against goals. The most performative teams in English Premier League are Liverpool with 3.69 XG90 plus XGA90 and Manchester United with 3.06 XG90 plus XGA90. Move on. The following parameter is XG90, XGA90. This parameter reflects how much the expected goals for of the team are better than its expected goals against. In other words, it reflects in how many times the dangerous moments that the team creates are better than the dangerous moments that the team allows to create her rivals. This parameter gives the opportunity to see the class of the team, to understand the level of the game, its style and tactics. For example, Newcastle XG90. XG90 parameter is 0.5, which tells us that Newcastle allows its rivals to create dangerous moments almost 2 times more often than creates dangerous moments itself. Brighton is almost equal in both aspects, for and against goals. Its XG90 parameter is 0.96. Liverpool has 3.1 XG90 parameter, which means that the team creates 3 times more dangerous moments than allows to create to her rivals. In fact, XG90 is the parameter that allows estimating the level of a team. The next group of parameters, 0.3 max, was developed by the owner of expected score. It is based on the following idea. Most dangerous moments with very high XG include a lot of luck. Often it's a rebound or a very successful deflection when the player makes a shot to empty goals. These are also penalties, reflection from the hands, etc. So most of the shots higher than 0.3 XG includes the elements of randomness, accident, and have a lot of variances. We equate all the moments from 0.3 XG and higher to 0.3 XG. It allows us to reduce the variance in the moments with a high XG value to get more accurate parameters that can be more reliable. 0.3 max parameters are very, very useful for strategy development, especially in strategies for outcomes. XG90 0.3 parameter is the equivalent of XG90 parameter. The core distinction is that XG90 0.3 max is based on reduced stats, where the highest value of a shot is 0.3 XG. The same way calculated XG90 0.3 max parameter, the equivalent XG90 parameter with the same distinctions, such as XG90 plus XG90 0.3 max and XG90 XG90 0.3 max. The next group of parameters are index and no index parameters. The parameters of the index and no index group form the team's power rank, which shows the power of the teams taking into account the schedule, the calendar of the matches that played. Power rank purpose is to reduce variance, which can occur at the start of the season because of the distinction in the schedule. Some teams at the beginning of the season have a more difficult schedule, and some have more easier. But at the end of the season, the influence of the schedule fitted. That is why important to use the power rank at the start of the season. If the team had an easy schedule, if its rivals were weak, its XG90 no index parameter would be less than the XG90 parameter. If the team's rivals were strong, everything goes backwards, and the XG90 no index parameter is more than the XG90 parameter. Close to the end of the season, this difference would be less and less distinctive. And in the final days of the season, the difference between XG90 and XG90 no index parameter might be only several hundred of XG. For example, at the moment of the 14th day of English Premier League, Liverpool has 2.79 XG and 2.76 XG90 no index. They are almost equal, which means and the influence of the variance has fitted to this day. But if we open the results for the first 6 days, we will see the different parameters. Liverpool's XG90 parameter was 2.88. XG90 no index was 2.44. That is evidence that the Liverpool schedule was weak. The group of index parameter is based on a ratio. The average ratio of a team is 1. If the team parameter is less than 1, the team is weaker than the average team in the league. If the team parameter is higher than 1, it is stronger than the average team from the league. Chelsea has 1.4 XG90 index and performs its dangerous moments 40% better than the average team from the league. Newcastle 0.68 XG90 index parameter means that Newcastle performs its dangerous moments 32% worse than the average team from this league. The group of no index parameters have the same meaning, but they are based not on the coefficient. They bases on league productivity. Both index and no index parameters are important from beginning until the middle of the season. These are the parameters of XG statistics. Also, we provide the opportunity to see the parameters for the different scores. You can choose them at the different tables. Sometimes it is important to check how the team performs for the different scores. You can check the level of a game for a 0-0 score,
draw,
when the team is leading in one goal, leading two or more goals, losing in one goal, losing in two or more goals.
The same you can see that for different groups of parameters.
One of the table consists of the results for the last 5 matches. What else can you do with the tables? You can choose a season. We have a huge database with the XG stats for several years, for most of the championships. You can choose the part of a season. For example, if you want to get the results only for the first 7 days of English Premier League, including the 7th day, choose the dates in the calendar from the 13th of August to the 16th of October. Now we have the results only for this part of the season. Also, you can choose the minutes of a match. For example, you want to know how do Liverpool spend the first half. Choose the minutes from 0 to 75 and check the results. Now you understand how to use the XG statistics from our spreadsheets. Use this video as a guide and learn how to use XG statistics. XG is a powerful tool for match analysis and sports betting. You can use it for value bet searching and for developing sports betting models. In the next video, we will discuss how to use XG statistics in our sports betting software, XG Manager. Subscribe to our channel, click the bell to get the new videos and become a professional sports bettor. Visit our website expectedscore.com to get XG statistics for 75 championships.